My name is Jillian Sullivan. We are at the CBS lab, the Computational Behavior Science Lab at Northeastern University, and I am a new postdoctoral fellow here. I study autism. I'm definitely an autism researcher now, and that came about purely through my work as an undergrad student studying it. I was fascinated by autism because, A, it's such a mystery. I think I'm always drawn to things that are unsolved and, you know, we want to find answers for. But I also really liked the constellation of traits that we see in autism. The fact that there are some difficulties and weaknesses and some struggles in a lot of areas, especially areas that I find so automatically easy to do. But much more so, I like the interesting patterns of strengths that we see. Things that you wouldn't necessarily expect to come from what we always are calling a disorder. And I really think that was what drew me into it. I wanted to know not only why these children, adults were struggling with certain things, but why they were doing so beautifully, so profoundly well on other aspects of life. We've created a system. It's a video capture system combined with some time-synchronized portable psychophysiology tools looking at skin conductance and sleep measures and looking at how we can actually put these in kids' homes for a while to see if we can break down that fourth wall. We bring kids into a clinic and we expect that we're going to get as much as we can out of them out of that hour they're at the clinic, but that's not them. That's not life. This, you know, it's absolutely not ecologically valid. So we're trying to bring this into homes to see if we can capture both research and for clinical and diagnosing purposes a bigger picture of what kids' strengths and weaknesses are and how that might relate to their physiological and their sleep patterns. We are also working on a mother-baby study and some couple studies to look at how people interact together. So looking at how physiological and behavioral work together over time, seeing how, you know, if a baby is upset, is the mother also upset? And can the mother calm the baby down by regulating her own body signs and body language. How does this work?
Okay, so what we can set up is we can have a video camera in the classroom where we're focused in on the kid. We can have sensors, so he's got a three-axis accelerometer, which is a sensor, so if it's on a known limb at a known orientation, then I know where his limb is in three-dimensional space.
Psychology is the human experience. What makes us human? And what especially I like is what makes us social beings. I can do statistics on it and run studies and look at it, or I can write poetry about it. There's not that much of a difference in the end. I enjoy thinking about how to design a study and how to find the answers, but I enjoy it because I want to find the answers. I do statistics because I want to find the answers. It's that designing the question and answering the question that I think is so interesting. And that can be any question, and that can be almost any answer. I think that the best ideas come from interactions, especially Oliver. Some days we literally just talk. We design studies, we talk about different implications, we talk about different ways we could address the question, different questions we could ask, how we could do it. And there's no way that I could have come up with that on my own. He probably wouldn't either. It's in the merging of our ideas, merging of different connections between different areas of science and psychology and even technology, now that I'm in this more technology-focused lab. Think closely about what it is you're interested in within those creative endeavors, within those artistic endeavors. If it's the human you're interested in, it's only going to help anything you do to have a better understanding of the human. So regardless of whether you're going to end up in your English or your creative arts or your any field, it's worth just picking up something on psychology, anything, and getting a better idea of what is going on with the human. It's not all science. It's not all wet lab. It's not rats if you don't want it to be. It can be pulling together different subjects, finding old archaic journals, finding old articles about something, pulling it all together into a new theory, new idea. And if that's something that interests you, then psychology and science is the way forward for you.